out there along with Michaela Olson. And the other guy out there is Noah Fletcher. Here's a pass and an interception. Here's a goal for Prairie Center. They'll take a 1-0 lead. It was Noah Fletcher giving that loose puck off the rebound. The shot was from the far side. It came right across and in a wide open net. And actually an easy goal for Noah Fletcher, who has scored. He is a sophomore. And Prairie Center scores first. They lead 1-0. There's only 2 seconds to go in this period, so Prairie Center will start out the second on the power play. Here's a chance and a goal! Will it count? It was 2.6 remaining. Off the faceoff, it came off to the side, and Josh Paninski hit it in. Now, let's see if it counts. 5-on-4, that's what I thought. Prairie Center has the man advantage. For under a minute to go. In the penalty, Fletcher has it on his stick on the far side, banks it off the boards, back to the point, to the blue line. Ritter back to Fletcher, back behind the net now, back to Fletcher, he scores! Beautiful play for Prairie Center. Fletcher, depressor, back to Fletcher, and he put it in, his second goal tonight by Noah Fletcher, and it is now 3-1 Prairie Center on the power play goal. By Michaela Olson out there again for Prairie Center. Fletcher with a bump in the corner, takes another hit, tries to get it free, kicked around. Danielson for Prairie Center, tries to move in front, has a chance and can't get to it though. Ran into a stiff check that time, it goes down. That was Brandon Bailey. Here's a deflection in front and it's loose. Did it go in? They say a goal! A goal for Prairie Center. Breckenridge is upset that the net was dislodged, but the official was pointing and he said it was a goal. There was a big scramble in front. We'll see who gets the credit. But it's going to be a goal and a 4-2 lead for Prairie Center. So 4-2, Prairie Center. 13:41 to go in the third. Breckenridge was claiming that the net was knocked back before the puck went in. An unassisted goal for Ryan Ritter. He was the one that scored. Number 7, Ryan Ritter, gets the goal, his first tonight. Power play for Prairie Center. Prairie Center leading 4-2. Face off in the zone of Breckenridge. And Mettenberg tried to get it, got it in his skates. Here's a deflection in front, comes back in. Froseth holds the zone. Froseth along the near boards. Place it in front of man, it's open, and here's the shot, and a goal! Scoring for Prairie Center is going to be Josh Paninski, his second of the night. It is now 5-2. So Prairie Center scores on the power play. Also Zach Mettenberg. Mettenberg tried to clear it, and it jumped over the stick. And here's a 2-on-1 here for Prairie Center. They will come down on a sliding shot. The rebound is a goal! Scoring is Brandon Bailey. A shorty will make it 6-2. Pull it back out. Michaela Olson is back to get the loose puck. Right side now to Rutten. He'll skate it across into the Breckenridge zone. Getting to the backhand, looking for a shot, nothing there, plays it back behind. Zips it around to the near side. Getting there, now is going to be Noah Fletcher at the point. Fletcher will have his pass deflected, back into the corner. Digging it free is Prairie Center. On the play, Bailey will play it in front, it got to the goaltender, the rebound is off to the side, now another chance, is still in the crease, they jab at it, comes back, Michaela Olson will shoot it, a save, and they'll face off. Oh, Michaela Olson nearly had a goal. Had a great opportunity that time. Back behind the net. And trying to get to it here is Tyler Christensen. Tries to play it up. They tangle up. Back behind the net again. And kick it free, boys. Here we go. Now it's played in front and the goal is scored. There you go. Once it got free, it was Andrew Danielson. Everybody was kind of standing around there for too long, and finally Danielson came up with it, got it past the goaltender, and it's now 7-2.